Hello and welcome. In this video, I'll show you how to change the IP address on a managed switch and make it permanent. A common reason for having to change the IP address is when the switch is set to a static IP on a subnet that is different from the subnet of the rest of the network. While the managed switch will work and pass data just fine, even though it's on a different subnet, you will not be able to log into it to take advantage of any of the functions that a managed switch offers. By default, all Luxul managed switches are set on a .0 subnet. As shown here, you can see that for the purposes of this example, we're using a .1 subnet to show the difference. Let's go through how to change the switch to a .1 subnet. The first thing I'm going to do is verify what subnet I'm on. So to do this on my Mac, I'm going to go click on the Wi-Fi icon. And I'm hardlined in, so I'm using Ethernet, not Wi-Fi. I'm going to go to my network preferences. Click on the Ethernet connection that I'm connected to, and verify that I'm on a .1 subnet. This is something you can easily do if you're not sure what subnet you're listed on. It's the third number that you want to pay attention to. So in this case, we have 192.168.1 is the third number. So now that I've verified that I'm on a .1 subnet, I want to go and bring up a web browser. In my browser, I'm going to go to the URL bar and type in 192.168.1.1 to get into my router. Type in my username and password, and you can see that I'm in. However, remember, our switch is set at a .0.4 address. So if I try to type that in, 192.168.0.4, I'm not able to access the switch because I'm not on a .0 subnet. In order to get access to the switch, I need to change the subnet that my computer is on. So let's go back to my network settings screen. Go back here and open my network preferences. Click on the Ethernet connection that I'm connected to. And instead of using DHCP, I'm going to change it temporarily to be manual. Now, in a Windows machine, this is called a static IP, and the concept is the same. Apple just calls it manual. So we'll click on manual, and I'll type 192.168.0.3, any IP address other than the device you're trying to connect to. Subnet mask will be the same, but we need to change the router setting here, or the gateway, as it's sometimes called, to .0.4. In this case, you want to set the router or gateway to the same IP address as the device you're trying to log into. So we'll hit apply, and you'll notice that I am now on a .0 subnet, and it says I'm connected. So let's go back to my web browser, and if I click on this again, instantly I'm into the switch. So I type my username and password, which in default is admin. And you can see that I'm now into the switch. I want to go to the configuration setting, quick setup, system, and then IP. You'll notice right in the middle here under IP interfaces for IPv4 that the address is set to .0.4. I'm going to change that to .1.4. Now please be sure that whatever IP address you set here is outside of your DHCP range that's set on your router. We'll talk about that in just a moment. So I'm going to go down here, that's all I have to do, and I'm going to hit save. And now this save is instant, but it's not yet permanent, and we'll talk about that in just a moment. But you'll notice right here up at the very top that I have now lost my connection to the switch, because as soon as I hit save, instantly it changed to that IP address. So now I need to get off of a static IP and back to DHCP. So I will go back to my network settings and change it from manual back to DHCP and hit apply, and it will now ask for an IP address from the router. You can see that that has just happened. So now we'll go back to our browser, and instead of 0.4, we'll change this to be .1.4, and you can see that I'm right back into the switch because now it's on a .1 subnet address. Please keep in mind that if you're already on a .0 subnet, you do not have to change your computer to be on a static IP. I'm showing how to do so in this video, just so that you'll know how, in the case where you are not on a .0 subnet to begin with. Now, there are two things that I mentioned that we'd talk about in just a moment. Let's go over both of those now. The first thing I said was that the change to the IP address on the switch was instant, but not permanent. And there's a reason for that on managed switches. Managed switches have both a running configuration and a startup configuration. One is permanent, one just runs in instant memory. So let's go back to our IP config screen. And remember, the save button here puts it into instant running memory. In order to make it permanent, I actually want to close the configuration window and go down to Administration, Configuration, and Save Startup Config. Once I hit this button, now it will be permanent, and if the switch ever gets rebooted or power cycled, it will come back up as a .1, .4 address and whatever other configuration I have set inside the switch. The other item I mentioned has to do with the router. Remember I said you want to make sure and set your IP address for your switch outside of your DHCP range that's in the router. So if we go back to the router, we can go to Network and DHCP Server, and it will tell me right here what my DHCP range is. I am listed at 100 to 200, which is the default in Luxul routers. So I know that anything that is before 100 or after 200 is outside of the range. So as long as I set that IP address for that switch outside of the DHCP range, I will not have any conflicts on the network regarding the switch. You also want to be sure to not set the IP address of the device that you're setting on a static IP, in this case the switch, as the same IP address as any other device on the network. Remember, it's one IP address per device, and in order to avoid conflicts, they must all be unique to each device. That's it. That's all you have to do to change the IP address in a managed switch. Thanks for watching.